we'll see that Newton's method is the fastest method of root finding. And you should use it when you need a fast method. But for Newton's method, you need to be able to take the derivative of the function that you're finding the root of. Sometimes that's not possible. The next best method then is Secant's method, where we're going to approximate the derivative of the function using two points on the function. So to derive Secant's method, let's start with Newton's method. So Newton's method is xn plus 1 equals xn minus f of xn over f prime of xn. If you can't find f prime of xn analytically, then what you can do is add an additional point to your iteration. So to get xn plus 1, we can use xn and an additional point x sub n minus 1, and then find an approximation to this derivative using the value of the function at xn and xn minus 1. The line that goes through these two points, f of xn and f of xn minus 1, is called the secant line to the curve. And that's why this is called the secant method. So what we do then is we approximate this derivative. So f prime of xn is approximately delta f over delta x. So f of xn minus f of xn minus 1 over xn minus xn minus 1. Okay? So that's the normal definition of the derivative when xn minus 1 approaches xn. Okay? But here there are two distinct points. Okay, so that defines the secant method. We can try to compute the square root of 2 again. So remember, the square root of 2 is this 1.41421. Okay? And the function that we want to find the root of is f of x equals x squared minus 2. So the solution to this is the square root of 2. If we're going to use secant method, then we're going to approximate f prime. So the secant method would be xn plus 1 equals xn minus f of xn is xn squared minus 2. F of xn divided by f prime of xn. So divide by f prime of xn, then we have the denominator here, xn minus xn minus 1, all over this numerator. So f of xn is xn squared minus 2 minus x sub n minus 1 squared minus 2. So the 2's cancel, and that becomes xn squared minus xn minus 1 squared, okay? That would basically be your numerical iteration. Since I'm doing it on the light board, I want to make the calculation as easy as possible. This n squared, xn squared minus xn minus 1 squared factors so that I can cancel this xn minus xn minus 1, and we get xn minus xn squared minus 2 over xn plus xn minus 1. And we simplify this a little bit more. We put it under a common denominator. We have xn squared minus xn squared, so that goes away. We have xn minus 1 minus minus 2 will be a plus 2 divided by xn plus xn minus 1. Okay, so that will be an easy calculation by hand. So to demonstrate then the convergence of this, In Secant's method, then, you need two starting values. So we'll start with x naught equals 1 and x1 equals 2, which turns out to bracket the root. Newton's method, you only need one starting value. So that's another kind of disadvantage of Secant method. But as long as these two values are close enough to the root, it should converge. Then Secant's method gives us x2. So here we have x2. So that would be x1 times x0. So 2 times 1, x1 times x0, plus 2 divided by 2 plus 1, right? So this is 4 divided by 3, which is just 1.3 repeated. Okay, so that's, we go from 1 to 2 to 1 point to 4 thirds. Then the next one, x3, using this formula then, would be 4 thirds times 2 plus 2 over 4 thirds plus 2. This would be 8 thirds plus 2 divided by 10 over 3. So this turns out to be 7 fifths, okay? Which is 14 over 10, so 1.4, okay? And then so on, x4, the last one I'll compute, will be x3 times x2, so 7 fifths times 4 thirds, plus 2 divided by x3 plus x2, so 7 fifths plus 4 thirds. And then if you put that all together, you get 58 over 41. And in fractions, in decimal, 1.414. And the last two digits are 63. Okay, so 1.414. So we see that this already matches to the square root of 2 over here. So the convergence is pretty fast. Okay, so this is illustration of Secant method. So let me summarize. We've learned the bisection method. You keep the root bracketed, so it always converges, but the convergence is very slow. We learn Newton's method. You have an initial starting guess for the root. You have to be able to take the derivative of the function analytically. And then the convergence is very fast. Finally, we have the Secant method. You need two initial guesses for the root. The root doesn't have to be bracketed. It could be, but it doesn't have to be. You approximate the derivative in Newton's method using the difference formula for the derivative. You usually use Secant method when you don't know how to take the derivative of this function analytically, but you can evaluate it at any x that you like. Secant method converges fast, not as fast as Newton's method, but much faster than bisection. So we'll be discussing then the theory behind the convergence of these methods in the next two videos. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.